Hello everyone, I am Yves Medina, a fourth year Juris Doctor student at the Ateneo Law School. In this channel, you will see videos about law school, law, and my personal advocacies. For today, I'm going to show you a picture of the life of a law student during exam season. So if you're interested to see kung gaano kasi lumuot ang buhay namin during exam season, please continue watching. So before anything else, siguro i-disclose ko lang na what you're going to see is the life of a fourth year law student na meron lang 4 exams this semester dahil review classes na lang and yung electives ko walang exam. So yay! But this is not what you are going to experience when you are in first year, second year, and third year. Especially second year and third year dahil noon, sa 9 days ng exam, meron kaming exam. So 9 consecutive days except Sunday, meron kaming exam. So ngayon, 4 lang yung exams ko. Kaya medyo maluwag yung schedule or yung exam season ko. At yun yung makikita ninyo. At hindi ko to naumpisahan before yung first exam ko dahil tax review yung first exam ko at sobrang kabado ako nun, so hindi ko na document. Anyway, ang dami ko na naman sinasabi. At eto na nga, eto na ang exam season ngayong first semester. 1, 2, 3!
Ang hirap magpanit mag-isa. Look. Oh, tax. Midterms ko in 1 hour. Bye.
Hello! So, it's the morning after my tax law review exam and I'm feeling a bit recharged kasi, and happy dahil walang exam today as compared before na almost every day yung exam. So, yeah. And I'm having my brunch. Pancakes! So, hindi lang ang pang-pang ang may pancakes. Pero hindi lahat ng may pancakes may pang-pang. So, after this, I'm going to study na and let's see what I can share with you. Hi, so I'm just preparing for my evening run. So nag-squeeze ako ng quick workout before running. Kasi usually I do workout in the morning and in the evening. Bakit ito? Bakit nag-maangat? Okay, so I do workout in the morning and in the evening given kasi na hindi masyadong gumagalaw dahil lagi nasa condo lang. I force myself to work out twice a day. And now I'm going to run for 30 minutes outside. But of course with my face mask. And after, pagka-uwi, I'll shower after running, tapos mag-aaral na ulit. So, yun. Ayan, so tapos na ako mag-jogging and tapos na rin ako mag-shower and mag-aaral na ako. Yung quota ko for tonight ay 100 pages. So I have to finish it and this is an accountability statement. And it's just with it. So to help me do that, I will use my Forest app. Okay, so for 2 hours, I'll study. So, study with me. Hi! So, hindi ko natapos yung quota kanina. Kulang ng 20 pages. But since it's my bedtime, at di ako magpupuyat, I'll sleep na. And I'll just start early tomorrow. So, good night! Hello, so this is the day before my midterm exams in PolyRev under Professor Cruz. So, for today, ang goal ko is to finish yung book and then I'll read my notes and also yung case doctrines na sinend ng aking soul sister. na si Pat Gal. Love you. Thank you. Tapos, tomorrow, yung day itself na exam, I plan to read CODAL and memorize. So, yun. Study with me again. May all your Christmases be white. I have no friend to wish me greeting. Hello, so it's 3 hours before my examination in political law review, and usually kapag ganitong oras nasa power plant na lang ako kumakain ng ice cream kasi alam ko hindi na ako makakapag-absorb kasi parang bangko yung utak ko na may cut off para sa clearance. Like usually 3 hours before the exam shutdown na siya, nag-cut off na siya, ibes wala na akong tatanggaping information sa'yo. So now pinipilit ko pa rin basahin itong itong notes ko and CODAL. So, ayun, balitaan ko kayo after ng exam and hopefully, makasagot naman tayo sa exam. So, ayun, balitaan ko kayo later. Bye-bye! Ayoko na magbasa lalo pag malapit na exam kasi feeling ko pag may pinasok pa ako, may lalabas. Alam mo yun, pag pinilit ko pang mag-aral ngayon, baka yung mga na-memorize ko, umalis sila. Kaya ayokong alugin yung utak ko, ayokong gumalaw, ayokong may kausapin. Gusto ko mag-exam na kasi baka lumabas yung mga naaral ko. So, exam na. Sent my exam already. Also, if mapapansin nyo, nagpalit akong damit. Kasi instruction ni attorney ni Professor Cruz is to take a bath before the exam. So I did. Anyway, pahinga na ako. I'll rest for tonight. And tomorrow I'll start reviewing for Cream Rev. Ang baba ng energy. Wait, wala talaga ako energy. Bye. Hello. Ayan, mataas na ulit yung energy ko. Grabe talaga kagabi, like literal na naubos ako after the exam. Nakita niyo naman yung video. It was an actual reaction right after I submitted my exam. So, naka-recover naman na tayo. Like, diretso tulog talaga ako. Hindi ako nakapag-Netflix or nood ng videos. And today, I started reviewing for my criminal law rev exam. And yung coverage niya ay buong book 1. Ng RPC. So, I have to, since 3 days yung gap between yung exam yesterday and yung exam sa Cream Rev, I intend to, or yung strategy ko is to finish the book or spend 2 days reading the book. And then, yung last day will be spent reading CODALs and reviewers, memorizing elements and requisites. And today, happy din ako kasi yesterday nag order ako ng apple pie and ng chicken pie. So sobrang recovery / comfort food niya for me to actually reward myself for my tax and poly rev exams. So yeah. Yeah, my pies are here. So naisip ko na since halos nag-aaral lang yung nakikita nyo, pakita ko naman na madalas din akong kumain. And dahil meron tanong si Amy dati sa previous video na ano daw yung pinaka nag-struggle sa law school and how did I overcome it, I'll try to answer it while eating. So, saan ba ako pinaka nag-struggle sa law school? I think sa sagot sa exam. Kasi, you know, taking legal exams is different and it's a skill that you can learn and develop. Until now, I think I'm still learning how to, you know, parang polish my exam taking skills. Kasi iba talaga siya. Sa amin, you are advised to use ALAC as a format. ALAC meaning answer, legal basis, application, and conclusion to the question asked. Pero kasi aside from that, may iba pang factors to consider in answering legal exams. For example, issue spotting. Kung ano ba yung hinihingi based on the facts given. Kasi may mga irrelevant facts eh. And then yung question, makita mo na parang hindi mo alam kung ano ba yung hinahanap na legal issue. Kasi madaming legal issue na pwede kang i-discuss. Pero makita mo, it's a skill to identify based from the framing of the question kung ano lang yung hinihingi. Kasi when you discuss things that are not relevant to the question, hindi ka makapag-full points or sometimes hindi pa tama yung issue, yung sagot mo since hindi tama. Ano, bakit may langaw? Nasa 16th floor ako. Paano nagkalangaw dito? Anyway, so yun. Yung pag-take ng exam, isa yun sa pinaka-nag-struggle ako kasi it's really a skill. And as an overthinker, sometimes I tend to assume facts. So, dapat hindi ka mag-assume ng facts kapag nag-take ka ng exam. So, wait, I'll try this chicken pie. Okay. So, I like it. And, naalala ko yung chicken pot pie ng Starbucks. And usually, yung kinakain ko, kapag gusto ko ng mabigat na pastry habang nag-aaral, hindi ako makaalis to grab lunch or dinner. Yung chicken pot pie ako sa Starbucks habang nag-aaral. So, and, tastes the same. Or better, kasi feeling ko less preservative to. Then, sometimes it's a strategy to, lalo pag mahaba yung mga exams, kung kay secret, malalala kung mahaba yung mga exams, start first with the question. Actually, kahit hindi mahaba yung exam, start first with, look at the question first, para pag binasa mo yung facts, kaya mo nang i-distinguish alin ba yung mga facts na magpo-focus ka. Kasi alam mo sa dulo kung ano yung question na sasagutin mo. So, yon. I'll continue eating and then I'll see kung ano pang pwede kong ma-share sa inyo. So, thank you! Hello! So, it's just 2 hours before the midterm, before my midterm examination in criminal law review. And right now, I'm just reading my notes and also CODAL. Buong CRIM 1, yung coverage. I was able to finish the book. Yay! Anyway, so ayun, balitaan ko kay later after ng exam. Bye-bye! Grabe, ang sakit ng mata ko talaga every after exam na online exam. Tingnan nyo, oh, namumula. Anyway, like as usual, ubos na naman ako. Naiyak ako. Ubus na. Recharge ulit ako. Pangit ko pa. Sige na nga, bye-bye. Earlier, na-share ko na isa sa pinaka-nag-struggle ako is how to take legal exams. But reading the news today, I realized na yung pinaka-struggle din pala as a law student is on how to convince other people to keep their faith in the justice system. Na sa Pilipinas, posible ang justisya. I remember back in first year, Republic versus Reno was promulgated. And at that time, I got really frustrated and disheartened. Parang sabi ko, may sense pa ba yung pag-aaral ng law kapag alam mo na ganito yung nangyari, na para mas umiiral yung power. And when your politicians bastardize the rule of law, the constitution, parang bakit pa ako magiging abogado, di ba? And I was really, really thinking then, worth it pa ba? Gusto ko pa ba? And I remember, there was a lightning rally after the decision was promulgated in Ateneo Law. And nagsalita doon si Dean Candelaria. And I remember him saying na, I want you to remember that feeling of frustration, of rage, of that anger. So that when you are in the position of power, when you are eventually practicing the profession, you wouldn't do anything that would remind you of that feeling. And that was important to me then. Kasi yun yung nag-push sa akin. That made me say to myself and promise myself na, Ives, you have to study even harder. You have to master the law by heart. Para pag naging abogado ka, you will use everything that you know and lahat na makakaya mo to never allow these things to happen again. So yun talaga yung naging drive ko until now, 4th year ako, na kahit anong nangyari dyan, it frustrates you, sometimes it disheartens you, but you know, ang inisip ko na lang, I have all the more that I have to become a lawyer. Kasi alam ko, kapag ako naging abogado, hindi ko hayaan mangyari yung mga to. Kaya sa inyong mga law students na katulad ko na na-frustrate o sa mga gusto maging abogado pero hindi sure kung worth it pa ba maging abogado sa Pilipinas na parang walang kustisya o para lang sa mayaman ng kustisya, I pray to the Lord or to any divine being or kung saan man kayo naniniwala or kung wala man kayo pinaniniwalaan na we will all be lawyers. We will become lawyers. And para sa mga tao naman na who would want to become a lawyer to further their personal interest at the expense of the rule of law, bahala kayo. Wala akong pake sa inyo. So, yun, isa yun sa mga frustration ko bilang isang law student and isa sa pinaka nag-struggle ako on how to deal with the fact that I am studying very hard to know the law, to master the law, but when I see what's happening outside, it seems na hindi naman tama yung inaaral ko or parang binabaliwala yung inaaral ko. So that's is really one of the parang struggles that I experience as a law student. So, pero yun, let's keep the faith and hope is the only thing that we can hang on to. So, we hope that we will all become lawyers and we will be compassionate and we will be promoting and upholding the Constitution and human rights. So, ayun.
Morning. So, today is the last day of the exam week and we have Civ Rev for today under Din Mel. I'm a bit panicking kasi hindi ko natapos yung coverage last night, although natapos ko na siya ngayong umaga, but hindi ako ganun kaakal and I'm so tired. Pili ko kahit apat lang yung exam because yung load katumbas niya is apat na semester. I'm not sure. So, yeah, I'm gonna cram. Wish me luck and I'll update you later.
Sent my email already! My exam! Yay! So, I'm done with my midterms. Yung last was civil law review under Din Mel Santa Maria. And now, look at my stuff. They're packed already. I'll head to power plant dahil nandun yung parents ko. And after 3 months, I'm going home to Pampanga. Yay! So, I think that's it. I'm not sure if may papakita pa ako sa inyo, but that's my midterms grind. And I hope that you enjoy. Kung curious kayo kung ano ba mabuhay ng law student, I hope I was able to show you a picture of what our life is during exam season. Pero yun nga, as I've said earlier, review classes ako and 4 lang exams ko for this sem. So, baka hindi siya, hindi ganito yung nangyari sa akin ng first year, second year, third year. Although kahit 4 lang yung exam, super napagod ako kasi yung coverage nung mga exams ay halos isang sem per subject. Like, Crim 1, Tax 1, Consti 1. So, midterms lang coverage ngayon. Dati, buong sem siya. So, ayun. I hope you enjoy the video and like and subscribe. So, bye-bye. Stay safe. Thank you.